One of Metro Vancouver's largest marine crossing tunnel projects is making steady progress both at ground level and beneath Burrard Inlet. And this water supply tunnel will last for generations.
This is a major project for Metro Vancouver system, so the tunnel has been designed for 100-year design life.
The new tunnel runs about a kilometer from North Vancouver to North Burnaby and contains water mains that will replace older existing ones in Burrard Inlet. The tunnel will meet current seismic standards, and the new water mains will increase capacity by 50% to help serve the region's growing population. The tunnel is 5.8 meters in height, with plenty of space for the three new water pipes. Earlier this year, 214 sections of the pipe were painstakingly lowered down the North Vancouver shaft for installation in the tunnel.
Starts with getting a 50-foot chunk of pipe on the surface. We hoist it, rotate it to about 45 degrees, lower it to the bottom of the north shaft, rotate it flat again as it gets inserted into the tunnel, gets set on a pipe carrier. The pipe carrier then delivers it to the last welded joint in the tunnel.
At the North Burnaby end of the tunnel, construction work is largely focused on preparing an underground site for the valve chamber. A valve chamber holds pipe connections and valves that regulate the flow of drinking water. On the North Vancouver side, sheet piles are being driven into the earth to get ready for digging out another valve chamber site.
In this area, the groundwater is about this far below the ground surface at high tide and maybe this far at low tide. So when we go to dig that excavation, it's going to be entirely in the wet. So we'll drive the sheets, we'll dig it out in the wet, and then place tremie concrete that will allow us to then dewater it and complete the valve chamber construction.
Work on the second Narrows Water Supply Tunnel project will continue until at least 2025.